Everyone, my name is Ben David from eSignal. Before I go further, I need to perform a sound check. In the left-hand corner, you will see a chat window. Can you please type yes or why if you can hear me? Okay, great. Now, let's just cover a few more logistics before we begin. If the audio is not clear, or if you hear an echo while either myself or Rahul speak, try logging off Adobe Connect, then log back on. Unfortunately, there is not much we can do to help troubleshoot any audio or video issues you may be experiencing. Secondly, you can find our contact details below on the left bottom corner. Please take some time now to jot down that information. There is also a full screen option of Adobe Connect if the images you see are smaller than you prefer. However, keep in mind that this will disable the chat function that you might want to use later on. As a thank you for attending, this presentation is being recorded and everyone will receive a copy sometime afterwards. Now, a few things to discuss at this time. I wanted to share with you eSignal special offers. We have a special offers page and the URL is provided here. Some of the special offers include refer a friend and get credit, where you can get up to $100 credit by referring a friend to eSignal. To all new users, we offer a 30-day risk-free trial of eSignal 12, which is our latest version of our trading platform, and the link is provided here. And as a special thank you for attending today's webinar with Viratech, today's special offer is that if you subscribe to the Viratech indicator, we will provide you the second month free. And in terms of monthly pricing, it is $209 per month, but if you prepay annually, it is actually $159 per month. Also, I wanted to, for those of you who either subscribe or considering eSignal, I wanted to mention that we offer a plethora of training opportunities, everything from basic and advanced trading in eSignal 12, as well as how to trade in Forex and futures. There are obviously more webinar and events, either online or live, that are upcoming, and they can all be found on the eSignal learning page. At this time then, without further ado, I wanted to present today's presenter, which is Rahul Mohindar of Viratech Software. Rahul is a seasoned panelist regularly featured on CNBC India and CNN India for over a decade. His interviews and findings have been published in various newspapers and books. Viratech Software and eSignal have actually been partners for over 10 years, with Viratech selling the Advanced Get product since the early 1990s. Rahul is an active trader and has educated traders across the globe, including real lifetime trading events. He has been part of the multiplicity of events, including trading expos, conferences, and user workshops hosted across the globe, including the US, UK, Australia, Singapore, and India. Rahul started trading at an early age. His research and work rotates around highly practical lines for which he's best renowned for. His studies have been included and acquired by professional firms, including Thomson Reuters, for the award-winning MetaStock product line. During Rahul's presentation today, you will learn many things, including how you could detect sideways zones and save yourself from numerous signals, get an overview of the ATM breakout catcher and counter trend indicator, learn how to use the RMO2 when trading options, decode the trend with the inbuilt ATM trend decoder, trend decider suite, excuse me. You'd be able to get to see how the levels dynamically update and experience its automated interpretation, using volume to your advantage courtesy of the ATM SWI, which stands for Strength Weakness Index, enhance your trend intelligence with the ATM tick system that auto detects and grades new trends, including potentially intermediate tops and bottoms, detecting opportunity with ATM PowerScreener, including customized tips to detect what you precisely desire. In order to keep Rahul's presentation flowing well, I ask that you please hold your questions till the end of the presentation. Please go ahead and send your questions through the chat box and Rahul will respond in due time. With those details aside, please welcome Rahul Mohindar. And again, thank you for attending this eSignal webinar.
Well, thanks, Ben. That was a kind introduction. I hope everyone can hear me, and I just want to be sure about that. So just type in a Y in the chat box, and that'll allow me to shoot forward. Excellent. So today's presentation is about an add-on we created titled ATM PowerScreener. Interestingly, the add-on has been around for 3 years, and you know, we're glad to partner with eSignal to expand in its offering globally. In fact, it's been in use by professional traders, individual investors, and at the same time by you know, beginner level traders as well as advanced level traders. So it's quite versatile. It's got a multiplicity of indicators. It means we're really not talking 4 or 5 strategies here. We've got a suite of actually 30 different EFSs that we provide you, which kind of rounds up all together with you know, numerous strategies that you can position yourself into. So today I'm going to give you an overview of some of the core strategies which the ATM PowerScreener is very good at, and you know, some of the studies which you could immediately start applying you know, when you get the add-on. A quick disclaimer: well, obviously this presentation is not a recommendation to buy or sell a particular stock. It's rather a guideline on how to use this add-on and what this add-on can potentially do for you. We do to understand that trading in securities or any financial instrument carries significant risk, and this could amount to total loss of capital. And once we're done with that bit of formality, let's dive straight in. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is what's the goal of using an add-on like the ATM PowerScreener. The ATM PowerScreener is actually designed not to be a black box, but it's designed to be a suite of tools which helps you build up a rule-based approach. ATM, as the name says, it is automated trend modules. That's what the ATM stands for. The automated trend modules are modules that are automatically plotted in terms of buy and sell signals on your chart. They are automatically interpreted by the indicator. And at the same time, the power screeners is that side of the suite which actually finds these trades for you in real time. Well, this necessarily doesn't mean that you must use this in real time only. You could definitely apply to daily and weekly time frames. But yes, if you are trading, you know, shorter time intervals, whether it's a 2 minute or a 5 minute or a 60 minute, you can definitely apply it on any time frame of your choice. So it's not just giving you a set of studies, but it's also giving you a set of studies that automatically interprets, giving you a rule-based approach to work with, and at the same time giving you power screeners or tools which would detect these trades out for you. Now, the indicators, as I said, would mark buy and sell signals for you on the chart. Many of them would you know, color up backgrounds so that it becomes visually more interesting and understandable from a trading perspective. You know, I've been a trader right from my teens, as Ben was mentioning, and I can tell you that the need for something to get you rule-based, the need for something which gets you more visually into the chart, the need for something that makes you more hands-free, has really come, because we're in those days where we've got to focus more on our trading discipline, on our money management, rather than, you know, how do we detect the right trades or interpret the trends. So I think that's really the goal, to get you largely automated on that front so that we can take the next big step in terms of focusing on the trade rather than anything else. Now, interestingly, we've even built voice alerts, something which you know, I've not seen any program out there which does it, where you can actually get buy and sell signals or price alerts. You know, let's say a stock goes bullish or bearish, we could have a voice alert which says buy IBM or buy Apple or, you know, buy Euro FX. So it would give you a virtual voice, like a human voice, which speaks out from your computer, voicing it out to you. Now, the reason why we built that in is because we realized that a lot of traders may be sitting in front of their PC, but at times they may not be. They may be looking at something else at their desk or attending to something else which is in their workplace. But the voice alerts actually don't, you know, they remove the dependency of your eye and your concentration. So it gives you this little prompter, hey, buy IBM because, you know, there's a trend decider buy on it. So we've got, you know, these voice alerts really come in handy. So we've gone beyond the spectrum of just giving you little pop-up alerts or email alerts, and we've taken it to the next level with voice alerts, which makes it so handy and easy to use while in real time. Now, another very interesting thing is we've worked to breakout strategies, counter-trend strategies, as well as trailing models. So, you know, models which can help you trail your stop. Now, we've also built in specific setups for those of you in the options markets. And we've also got specific time-based indicators. So whether you're short-term or long-term, we could look at it. Now, obviously, this means the whole ATM PowerScreener suite as an add-on has a lot to offer. There are numerous set of tools, and I'm going to take this more individually because not tools are necessarily dependent on each other. So you can, you know, go with the strategy that you would like to work with, and you know, which suits your kind of time horizon or trading style. So let's start with an interesting indicator called the ATM SWI. The SWI means the strength weakness index. Now, whilst most indicators work off price, you know, whether it's a lot of the averages that you use or, you know, the conventional set of indicators typically people use would all depend on price. So if price goes above this, below that, breaks out of that, or, you know, there's a convergence or a divergence, it's the price which governs the trend. The SWI does things a bit differently. It actually uses volume as a more essential ingredient, which means the weightage of volume in the SWI is specifically mandatory, which means if I use it on a chart that doesn't carry any volume data, I am not going to be getting any signal. Now, what does the SWI do? It just draws a line across the chart. So if you can see the chart, this is a daily chart of Google, and what it's done for me is it's drawn out a blue and red line which is running across the price bars. And what you would observe is whenever these price bars have been above the SWI line, you've seen strength. So you've really noticed that the market's gone up November, December, January, which is the first half of your chart, and that's because we've been above the SWI level, and that kicked in right in the beginning. If you see the little yellow square, now the yellow square is something I've plotted out for you just so that you can get it understood, but we do have what we call a power screener which would detect these trades. So we'll come to that in a bit, but broadly that yellow square is going to be highlighted automatically for you via an email alert or via a voice alert that would pop up on your watch list. Now, what you see is every time this breaks down or closes below. So when you saw the breakdown mid-March or end March somewhere, you could see how the price actually declined quite a fair bit. Interestingly, the SWI is not just price dependent, which means obviously it can handle volatility fairly well. This whole patch, if you look at the last 3 months, June, July, August, you've seen a lot of up and down. Whilst it's been an uptrend, it's not been a very, very easy single slope uptrend. You've seen the back and forth. You've seen it go up and down. And, you know, the SWI kind of held it. It kind of gave you that sense, look, it might be dipping down, but probably an opportunity to buy it because it's still not weakened out. We still haven't got weak purely on a volume basis. So the SWI really encapsulates volume to a strong degree. Now, if you look at it on intervals, so if I look at the same Google chart now on a, let's say, a 30-minute, you would you know, get the same kind of feel. You would see how the volatility is handled equally well. So when the market breaks down, you see it, you know, on the 23rd of July when it broke down there, you see the whole drop down that comes in. Now, in between, you may find that you have a you know, like a little small buy that came up. So in case you can see my mouse pointer, that's great. If not, look at the little light pink horizontal line that we've plotted out there. When you get the buy, one of the simple rules we want to use is we want to buy above the high. So which means you close past the SWI line. The simplest test of strength for us is, just go past the high of that bar and you're qualified. So very simple qualification, buy strength, which means go buy the high when you get that SWI signal. So if you see in that case, we never really went past the high. A couple of ticks above the high is what we need to do. So we're really not even going long there. You've really been short all the way. Now, I'm not saying it's going to be perfect. There's no indicator that's going to be perfect. But then, you know, this is an indicator which works independently in more off volume. So gives you a very nice, interesting perspective, an amazing indicator to help you even trail some of those trades. Because look at the way it handles volatility. You see these four bars and five bars which suddenly dip up and down. But that really doesn't disturb the SWI or the strength weakness index excessively. So that's another good thing about the SWIs, the way it handles volatility, and that's really because it's factoring in the volume quotient of it. Now, when you look at what are buy and sell signals, now when you get a buy signal, look at where the up arrows are plotted on this chart. If the market starts closing past the SWI line and this is ticking in real time, you would get a alert or a voice alert or a text alert on your watch list the way you want it. So you can set your watch list the way you want, put in your stocks, you know, if you want to scan 100, 200, 300, whatever it is. So you set up a watch list which you think are stocks that you want to track and trade. You can set the SWI to work off a time frame that you think you're comfortable with. So let's say if it's a 30-minute or a 60-minute, whatever it is, and it would pop up alerts for you. Well, not pop up really, it would voice out alerts as well as, you know, give you little text labels on your watch list which give you these indications of buy and sell. Now, that's how it would look on a watch list. So when you look at this one, this is the SWI 15-minute that we set here, and this is not a real-time situation, but just a quick screenshot I took. Wherever you see red values of the SWI, you really know that's the point where the SWI is at, which basically means if the price goes above that point, it's going to be bullish. If it goes below that point, it's going to be bearish. Now, sell would mean that's the first time the price bars have actually broken through that SWI line. A buy would obviously come up when the first time it goes past or goes above the SWI line. And the values, the minute you see the color coding on the values, if you see red values, obviously the SWI is already in a sell mode. And if you see blue values, which in this case you see on two blue values whenever we did the screenshot, it tells you that those are the two where the SWI is below the price bars, giving you a signal of support and strength. Now, just to give you a quick background of how these alerts sound, we'll kind of run through that in a bit. But they're basically voice alerts that come up for you. And let's just pull it up on a chart. So that's how the SWI looks for you. So this is a chart of eBay right now, and you can see that the minute we went past the point there, so we closed past the SWI line, that's when we became bullish. And it's not been a straight line run up for eBay on 30 minute from there. You've seen a lot of back and forth. You've seen like 20, 25 bars, which really was sideways. It went up and down, up and down, and all it just looked at was, you know, the volume sink with the price still supported that this market should probably run up. Now, that gives you a sign that, you know, even at this time, you know, we're bullish and looking upwards. So that value that you see, 53.13, is the current value as we're ticking live on the stock. And, you know, that obviously keeps moving. And needless to mention, if I looked at this on a lower time frame, let's say if I said I want to look at this on a 15-minute chart, you would get obviously much quicker signals because really your time frames dropped. Now I would recommend you stay with one time frame and stay put on a particular time frame with the same set of rules to realize the kind of accuracy that it can deliver. Now you do see that there are points in time where things didn't work out. There's this phase where you saw a nice little drop, you got the nice big up move, but then you have a hiccup over there. But if you look at the kind of risk, you've shorted there, gave you a buy very quick and got you back into the trade, which is great. So nothing's perfect, as I said, there's no holy grail, but at the same time, you've got something which automatically very easily detected the trend for you and give you a sign that eBay is positive, and the way to trade on it is on the buy side. So how would you add the indicator? Very, very simple. I'll just remove all the studies I have on the chart right now. So we'll just do remove all studies. So insert study. And of course, you'd find more of this information in the manual or the user guide that we've written up for you. Get on to add on studies. And straight out, select the ATM SWI. The SW indicates chart window. And if you see an SWI PS, that's a power screener, which means it needs to go into the watch list. So that comes up there. And let's say if I want to add SWIs on my watch list, just go back into add-on studies and select the SWI, this time PS. Now by default, it does take the daily time frame. However, feel free to go ahead and change that. But one quick tell you, you've got a mix of blue and red colors on this column, which tells you it's a bit of a mixed market, at least in the symbols that I'm looking at here, because you've got a couple of red, a couple of blue. So it's kind of, there's no one-way trend to it. But let's say I put on something as low as a 5 minute, just to get an idea. So there you have a 5 minute says there's a Google alert on a 5 minute buy. So there you are. So this is auto detected, and this can be voiced out for you, which means you would actually get a voice alert that this is a stock that's coming up on your buy list. And let me try and see if I can give you, I can't route system audio on this, but I'm just going to try and put it on a computer right beside me to see if I can play back some sound alerts for you. Okay, so well, let's see if we have some. So when you're looking at sound alerts, you can actually set up signals on particular time frames, particular stocks of your choice, and they would just come up. Well, nothing immediately that pops up, but I'll keep a watch, and when I do see something that comes up, we'll try and show you how those voice alerts sound. But all right, let's get back to the SWI. So that's a fairly simple tool, and I think that's one of the missions is someone buying the ATM Power Screener or using the ATM Power Screener is really looking at making his life a little more simple in terms of interpretation, fairly straight line. A great study is the ATM Breakout Catcher. The ATM Breakout Catcher is now price-based. So like the SWI was very volume-based, this one's not volume-based, but it's price-based. So which means it's looking at strength and weakness when price breaks out based on a multiplicity of factors and indicators. So we've kind of bundled up a lot of conditions to build in, and those are price-driven conditions now to give you a sense as to whether a stock is breaking out or not. So the breakout catcher auto-detects breakouts, and the way it does that for you very easily is plots a bar color on your chart. So you see red bars, blue bars, and olive or khaki color bars. So the red and blue are very straight cut. Red is a weak bar, blue is a buy bar or a strong bar. whereas a khaki color bar is more of a neutral bar. The buy and sell signals, or points where it detects breakouts, are marked by vertical lines for you. And just to jump in very quickly, where you see the vertical lines there, those are points where we're looking at a sell breakout. Where you see a blue with a vertical line, that's a point where you see a buy breakout, and we're expecting strength or weakness from there. Now, in addition to that, what we've also mentioned to you in point number three there is consider a filter of what we call the ATM zone detector, which is actually the next tool I'm going to come to. But what does the zone detector do for us? The zone detector is a great setup which helps you figure out if a stock is in a dormant mode or a sideways mode. So which means if we can find stocks that are sideways or dormant, we don't want to necessarily take trades or signals at that point in time. We want to take trades where the market's more active or hyperactive, because if there's a signal which is backed with no volume and volatility, it's like a signal that's backed with no money. And you know, if you have that kind of a signal, you probably want to think twice if you want to take that trade. So when you get breakouts caught on your chart, you just want to double check if you're in a zone of potential sideways price action, or are you in a zone of active or hyperactive price action. And finally, of course, like we did with SWI, you trigger trades past a high or a low of the bar. So we'll take that stage by stage. Let's start with the signal we have here. Now, when you see the blue bar with the vertical line, that's when you say buy above the high. So whenever it ticks that high, which would be really on this bar somewhere, you go long. And when you go long, when you look down at the zone detector, you can see that the market is in what we call a hyperactive mode. Now, what's a hyperactive or a dormant mode? When you see the zone detector is the indicator that you see at the bottom, the green, the light green, and the dark green indicator. It's either at a value of 0 or 1. So if you're at a value of 0, this means that the market's dormant. And, you know, don't take new trade signals if you get it over there. So if I got a sell right there, and I want to sell below the low, I look at the market being at a value of plus 1. It means, yes, there is price and volume action, which means I'm at a potentially better point to take trade. So it doesn't matter what happens after you take the trade, whether it goes back to dormant or not. But what I'm really trying to get at is when you are starting with the trade, you've got something in the zone detector to tell you, hey, that looks a more qualified trade. That looks like a trade that's got some, you know, price and money action behind you. So the zone detector does a great job of filtering out trades. And I'm not going to say that it's going to filter out every wrong trade, but it does a pretty decent job of, you know, saving you from a lot of those sideways patches. You know, even if it saved me 5 out of 10 trades, I mean, that's a big deal, because one bad trade saved is a lot more when you look at it on the balance sheet. So just to run you through some signals, when you look at the sell, this is an Apple daily. The sell came when the zone was in a dormant mode or at zero. Now, you don't know if later on it's going to go active or hyperactive, but you know, you don't take that kind of a trade. Do you take this trade? Yes, because when you see the zone detector, it is definitely at a point where you are in a market that's hyperactive. Do you take the sell that comes in, probably the last bit of the chart there? We don't take this sell because we got that sell in a dormant market. So you don't want to take that trade, and you save yourself from the little hiccup. So a lot of these you know, corrections or hiccups or sideways consolidations, whatever name you want to give it, can really be you know, weighted out to a nice degree with the zone detector. So just to recap for you, the zone detector is dormant when it is at a value of 0. It is hyperactive when it is at a value of 1, and you can see that you've got the light green lines on it. That's a sign that it's hyperactive. And if you just see the zone detector at a value of 1, it is active, but it's not hyperactive, okay? Which means it is much better than a dormant mode, and trades are takeable even on an active mode. But the hyperactive kind of ups the relevance on those trades. So in fact, you could use the zone detector on any indicator you trade. It's kind of a more of a Google fit, which means if you are using it on, you know, any breakout style. So if you like to use it, whether it's with a MACD or whether it's an RSI with the moving average you trade or whatever you're comfortable with, now you can fit in the zone detector to see, you know, how the market's behaving in terms of a zone, and it would automatically figure out if the market's dormant, if the market's active, hyperactive. Now, you know, a lot of this information, if you think it's more to give you an overview, but we've got a nice user's guide. We've even got training that we set up for you, which kind of helps you walk through it in a much more, you know, personalized way. So it's fairly easy, because once you understand it, it's more about, you know, picking up trades and doing it, because as I said, finally, it'll all be automatic in terms of interpretation. So the breakout catchers, buys and sells, will just pop up as watch list alerts straight out on your chart. You don't have to make any special effort to start going one by one, stock by stock, figuring out, oh, do I have a new trade setup that's, you know, that's something that I want to do. Now, the next bit which we need to pay attention to is, how do we set up trading signals in terms of time frame? Now, when you look at the setup, you can actually configure a time interval. So get back into the platform and add a column, and this time I'm going to be adding a breakout catcher power screener. And what this does for me is marks out a background color, so which tells you straight out on the daily we seem to have more of a red background, which means these are stocks that are already running in a sell mode. So let's put on a daily chart here too. And again, let me just remove everything. Now, you know, if I have something which is in a red color, it means the sell's probably already fired in. And you can obviously plot the indicator on the chart too, just to make sure we're on the same page. So there you are. So since, say this is Walmart on a daily, it already gave you a sell signal maybe before in time, and that's why it's not actually typing out for you buy or sell. Now, there could be situations where you get a new buy or sell trade. So there you are, voice alerts, email alerts, compute when the bar closes, or do you want it to compute in real time? All those possibilities are there. So if I look at Walmart now on a 5-minute, do you see the buy stamped out there for you? It means that, you know, it's just gotten into a buy signal. So that pops up for you, gives you a voice which actually spits out buy Walmart 5-minute. And, you know, that gives you a, you know, fair signal. Okay, let's try and see if I can play that back through my other PC and give you a sense of how those alerts sounds. And coming up now, obviously the bigger your watch list is, it tends to take longer. Now you could have watch lists which have 10 different indicators running parallelly with, you know, 75 or 100 symbols. So you know, the possibilities are fairly extensive. Okay. Well, strangely, I don't have something which instantaneously comes up. But well, let's hope it. All right. So that was a signal which on JCP based breakout catcher indicator on a different time frame we set up there. So that's how they sound. You get these little voice alerts, and you know, we'll try and do a video that explains it later down. But very, very easy in terms of interpretation. So right up to putting it on your chart, marking out lines for you as to where the precise buy and sell points are. And at the same time, you do want to, you know, look at the zone detector and see that, all right, you can place that up right at the bottom and see, okay, maybe I don't want to take that because it's still in a dormant mode. And which is why you can see, even in this Walmart chart, I would have taken this buy trade because that buy was on a hyperactive. This is a 5-minute chart. This sell that I got is not worth taking because, again, it's dormant. And here too, this buy, we're not going to try and just jump in a trade without qualifying it, without looking at that zone detector. So, you know, that's the breakout catcher, very, very straight line. And I think that's really my approach, to be as practical and pragmatic as possible, to cut out a lot of the noise. So the three squares that you see on the chart, all these are points where the breakout catcher gave you a signal, and all you did was look down and said, no, dormant, 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 I'm not going to do it. This cell, am I going to take it? Yes. You know, am I going to take this next cell? If you see the zone detector, you know, supporting you, go take it. Now let's come to another nice system, which is really a suite of indicators, more than just one indicator, which I call the tick. It's one of the newest babies I did, and tick actually stands for Trend Intelligence Kit. Now the reason I codenamed that as Trend Intelligence Kit was because you've got stuff that's not only giving you breakout signals here, you also are going to get a flavor of counter trend signals. You also are going to get signals which auto detect tops and bottoms in real time. So there's a lot that goes into this tick. So, you know, let's get you focused on what the tick can potentially do for me. So when you look at the histogram right at the bottom, gives me a sense of the tick oscillator. The tick oscillator is an oscillator which is detecting my longer term trend for me. So for those of you trading on a more trending basis, you want to check that if the tick is really in a dark blue color. And you know, all right, let me just mute those sound alerts. So if you're looking at the tick in a dark blue color, that's a very strong sign. If you look at them in light blue colors, it probably means that I'm weakening out. And likewise, you have pink and purple for the negative. Pink when it starts getting bearish and purple when it's fully bearish. So it's a histogram that just, you know, when you see it above zero, it's bullish. Below zero, it's bearish. And that's the primary trend that I'm talking about. But this one gives you a nice vibe. It gives you a sense as to, you know, how bullish and how qualified it is. Because with those four color codes on it, you get a feel as to, okay, this is mildly bullish or fully bullish. And, you know, you can find qualified trades so much better. It's like feeling the trade before you actually take it. So just to share with you a very quick example here. If I looked at this setup here, which is a buy, you can see the arrows which are automatically marked on the chart. Now, the arrows are the second aspect to the tick system. The third is the bar color. So if you see a blue bar color, that's further supportive, and all of these work with different time scales indicators before they sync on and come onto your chart. And finally, you have what we call potential intermediate bottoms or tops. So if the market starts getting topish, it starts highlighting IT or intermediate top for you. The market looks like it's making a bottom, this marks out IB. And it doesn't do that 20 bars later. It does that on that bar. So while the market is ticking, it looks at a very factors as to whether there's a base build or a top build. And well, these are potential points where the markets may be topping or bottoming. And I'm going to come to the science of how we trade those tops, bottoms, how do we look at the diamond shapes and things like that. Just understanding what I call the ATM tick trend trade. The ATM tick trend trade is for those of you folks who really get into a trend, stick with it for a good amount of time, get a sense that the stock or asset which you're looking at is breaking out for, you know, a strong trend. So when you look at a combination of these things, the blue bar colors, you have the arrow that came up, and you see that, okay, great, this is a dark blue oscillator which is positive. That sets you up, and it tells you, look, that's a good buy signal to take. And you could get a second buy signal right there where you have a blue arrow, a bar that's blue, and you look down at your oscillator, it's definitely positive, and you know, you've got the signal that sets up for you as a dark blue, and you know, you're good to go on it. Now the important bit is to have the sync of the first three. So you know, when we're doing a trend trade, as I would call it, you're really looking at the oscillator being positive with a blue color on it. So either would be light blue or dark blue. Yes, you can take trades on a light blue because often the trend starts with a light blue and later on progresses into a darker blue color. You have arrow signals as pointers to you as to precise buy and sell points. And of course, you want your last qualifier, which is the bar color. So that oscillator will really align for you the trend of the stock that you're trading. Now the next bit which I want to talk about is the intermediate top and bottom signals, which is really a fun part of this, which is IT and IB. So when you see IT, it's a sign that these are intermediate tops which it's detecting, and obviously when you see IB, those are intermediate bottoms that it's detecting. It would also mark a little diamond shape above that bar's high where it feels it's an IT or an intermediate top. Likewise, a blue diamond below the bar where it senses an intermediate bottom. So these are just visual pointers for you in terms of the IB and IT. Now, all of this stuff, again, has power screeners. I keep stressing this because, you know, everything I do really has to have a scan to back it up and you know, give me opportunities in real time, because I'm not going to you know, looking around. You know, it's even going to give you something what we call a power buy, where it's synced that, all right, we have the arrow, we have the oscillator that's positive. So it would, you know, voice out for you power buy on, you know, IBM, which means based on the time frame you selected, it's checked this stuff is there. And the reason I'm explaining this to you so that you get a better sense of what it's doing under the hood. And IB and IT come in for what I call the squeeze buy setup. The IT is an indication of an intermediate top. Now, if you see an IT marked out, what's the obvious thing that's going to go across your mind? That maybe this is topping out, so I'm referring to this bar right there. Now, what happens is, if the low doesn't break of that bar, and the high gets clipped out, and that green line that you see, the dotted green line, is automatically plotted out for you to give you a sign that, look, if it's above this, it's no more a top, it's probably once again reversed back into the strong uptrend it was in. And what's the sign you're going to get what we call the squeeze trade? The squeeze trade comes in with a couple of criteria. First, you want to look at an IT where the oscillator is positive and dark blue in color, not light blue. All right? So when you look at that IT, now if you look at the IB, this bottom was great because it never broke the low of this. It in fact went above the high of it and boom, boom, boom. You know, we had the light blue oscillator and, you know, things really worked out. Now IT, an intermediate top in a very strong dark blue oscillator, that's the first sign that maybe this could just give you a reversal opportunity of what I call the squeeze buy. So squeeze buy means buy when the green dotted line gets broken out of. Keep your stops exactly at the squeeze bar low. And you can definitely filter that out a bit if you want to give a couple of ticks below that, no harm. And you can use a risk is to reward ratio. So if I'm risking a dollar on that trade, I want a dollar 50 at least, which is great because even if these worked 5 or 6 out of 10 times, we're looking at a fascinating risk is to reward ratio. And you know, we've obviously done a lot of vigorous testing into seeing that these ITs work good. Now the ITs, just to recap, for a squeeze buy has to be on a dark blue oscillator. The tick oscillator at the bottom needs to be dark blue, not just positive. We want to see it in dark blue. So if I had to broadly highlight for you, where is my trend trade? I'm just going to mark a T, that's my trend trade, and an S over here, that's my squeeze trade. The trend trade is when the trend starts out, and the squeeze trade is when you had the intermediate target labeled, low never broke down, and obviously it's no more going to be an intermediate top, bypass the dotted line. So the squeeze is a great risk is to reward setup, and likewise you can do this on the sell. So if you have something that's telling you intermediate bottom, the high of that bar is not really getting out, so how can you even think of that as being a bottom? So when it marks the intermediate bottom, if it breaches the dotted line, this time the dotted line on the downside, and all of this is automatic, whether it's the IB stamping, whether it's the dotted line that's plotted out that you see, that is done by the software. You don't have to plot that dotted line. And when the dotted line breaks down, you have a sell in place. Again, what's the risk? You just take that bar as your risk and reward. And well, in this case, you probably got, you know, for a dollar risk, you might have, you know, done $4 or $5. You've got much more than a 1:1.5 risk is to reward ratio. So to recap, the squeeze trade gives you a very good risk is to reward ratio on those trades. And that's what makes sense. So you can start with a 1:1.5, and then as you move up, you can shift your stops to your entry price and then keep trailing it if you're trying to push for more. So even on its own at a 1:1.5, the squeeze trades are great. And just to recap, a squeeze trade sell, we're looking at intermediate bottoms being marked. If the low breaks down, and this time the histogram, the tick oscillator, is negative with a purple color. Purple is the strongest form of weakness. A pink is a milder form of weakness. Now, in case you are, that, oh, I don't like the colors that I see and I want to change that. So if you say, all right, we want to switch the color for weakness to red and we want to shift it to orange, it's mildly bearish, you can do that. You can obviously edit the indicators right up on your screen. So let's say if I want to get into a quick page that I've got made for my tick oscillators. So, you know, that's how, and this is amazing because you can actually say, all right, I want to make my colors red if it's really weak. And instead of pink, I maybe want to use an orange. All right, so take your pick, what you like using. And that's how it looks. I mean, it's very simple and easy to interpret, gives you, such a nice feel as to where the stocks. So this is a 15-minute chart of AT&T. And you know, that gave you the first sign of a top came right there. And a top came and there was no squeeze buy. How do I know there's no squeeze buy? Well, obviously that dotted line was never broken out of, which means I couldn't really go long here if I was even attempting a squeeze buy. So that intermediate top stayed, and you know, you went light blue the first sign and then you went deep red, very weak. And even now, you're just continuing all the way. And all these IBs that you see over there, beautiful, because you know why? They are potential intermediate bottoms, which never really kicked in. You can see let's take the most recent one, intermediate bottom, a low breaks down, And you know, you can always consider a squeeze cell. Well, obviously you want to check if it's a deep red, ideally speaking. So a squeeze cell is when you're selling when there's extreme bearishness on the oscillator, and you're taking it from there. Now, for those of you folks who trade options, you know, the ATM RMO2 is another tool that I you know, set up. And the RMO2 is really something which detects a trend and puts it more in a binary form. So if you see the RMO2 on a chart, it looks a bit like this. You see a plus one value, which is positive, minus one, which is negative, and zero, which is neutral. Now, if you do see a zero, that's really my zone of doing options trading, when the market neutralizes or pulls back to zero. So every time the RMO2 pulls back from a minus level to zero, that's a point I could go in and buy put options. So in case you don't trade options, no big deal. You can still use the indicator. All I'm trying to tell you is buying puts is thinking that the market's going to be weak, and you frame up strategies which really give you signals to you know, go down. You take trades which are more on the downside. So if you're looking at the RMO2 for breakouts, that too is a possibility. Now, when the indicator goes from a minus one level or a zero level to a plus one, that's an up breakout, and you know, you can see that pretty much happening right there. So when you get that breakout coming in, that's a buy breakout or an up breakout, and when you see it breaking down, that's a down breakout that you see. Now, another interesting thing is where you buy calls and puts. We call these pullbacks. So wherever the oscillator typically pulls back, you know, the RMO2 is pulled back to a zero point, that's a point where you want to look at buying calls. And you know, the nice thing is when you're going to be buying calls right there, you've seen a, you know, like a 5 or 10 bar drop that's happened, and you know, you're using that drop as an opportunity to buy calls. And obviously calls are going to be much cheaper, or really you know, price-wise cheaper, simply because of the fact that, you know, you've had a little bit of a drop in the price, so calls are obviously going to be more attractive over there. Likewise, when you buy puts, you get this nice little, you know, blip back up. And this is a time where most people are thinking, oh, you know, oh, is the market really going to go up? And you can see, hey, this is my opportunity to buy puts. So when you see this little run-up that happens, puts are going to be cheaper, and this time you buy puts because your view is that the market's going to drop and get bearish. So now all of this again is beautifully detected for you in the power screeners once again. So just to give you a view, you can set up the RMO2. You can see minus one, plus one, and of course you want to see new ones, because you say, all right, I want to look at stuff that has just gone negative, or stuff that's just pulled back. So you can see in this case, this is a pullback to zero, and it pulled back, then, you know, PB stands for pullback. And obviously all of this is user configurable. You can set email alerts, voice alerts, set whether you want a voice for a buy or sell, you want a voice alert for a pullback, what color you want your fonts to be in for buy or sells, or pullbacks, intervals that you want to set. So, you know, it's beautifully done. I think it's fascinating. I mean, I've used this stuff, you know, in my everyday trading. I can tell you, you know, you've got to see it, feel it, use it to believe it, because it's so interesting the way it works. Because finally, it's simplified trading to such a degree, simplified analysis to such a degree that, you know, I'm actually thinking, how much of this trade do I take, or how much of that stock do I buy, or how much of this stock do I sell? It's not about you know, whether I buy or sell, is this bullish or bearish? I mean, you kind of walk out of that school, if you know what I mean. And you know, if you don't, well, in a few days maybe you will. And then we built a very nice suite of tools, which is the trend decider. This is actually 7 different indicators which we're putting into one screen. So broadly, there's a trend decider level which we have for the day, the week, the month, and an intraday chart. Let me simplify this. The trend decider is really to tell you that, look, if you're above a particular level, it's bullish for the day. If you're below a particular level, you're bearish for the day. Likewise, you could use it with a weekly level because you have a time frame of a week, or a monthly level because you have a time frame of a month. So, you know, if you have an intraday goal, you can set it to an intraday goal that you're working to. But I'll just show you the most commonly used one, which is the trend decider daily and weekly. And actually, I really like using that because it's so easy to, you know, trade with. So let's start by showing you the trend decider levels with a daily and a weekly level. So trend decider, set up pages so that we don't have to. And all of this can, you know, with just one click can come in. So when you look at the trend decider levels, what it's doing for you is marking out a green line and a red line. So the green line is a daily level. Now the daily level, if I just for a moment just remove the red line, it tells you that, look, if you're above the green line, if I look at it today, we've kind of pushed ourselves above that. We're bullish for the day. And if I'm kind of below the level, I am bearish for the day. So you can see in most cases over here, we've been really bearish. We've mostly been above it. We've never been able to close all this time. We've never really managed to do a single bar that closed above even the daily levels, which tells you how weak the stock is. So it tells you that's the resistance, and you know, it's weak. And majority of the time, we had these little blips up, and you know, those days were positive, definitely. And like you see, even today, we've got a little blip up, which tells you it's a positive day. But then you want to make a bigger sense and a better sense of what this trend looks like. And the way to do that is to plot your weekly. So when you plot weekly, you would get a red colored line, which now gives you a signal for the week. All right? So that's the red line, which is for the week. Now, if I had to simplify this for you very easily, if the price is below, or the price has closed below the daily and the weekly level, obviously that's the point where the market is weak. If the price closes below the daily and weekly level, that is a weak setup. Another very important criteria of weakness, which a lot of us overlook, is the fact that if this green line or the daily level is below the weekly level, follow me there. You see, ever since the 21st of July, we've seen that the green line is below the weekly level. That's an indication that the market has been weak from there, and that's where the trend changed. Prior to that, it was positive. You can see the green line was above the weekly level, and you see these nice big steps up, and the market was strong. So even though the market was sideways all this time, you said, doesn't matter, unless the green goes below the red, I'm not sure if it's weak. So you really change tact towards the bear side when you kind of see that breakdown, when the green slips below the red. Now, you know, the nice thing is, again, we've automated it. That's why the name is ATM. We've got stuff that automatically detects these trend changes for you, and we've got stuff that automatically interprets it. So all I need to do now is, you would typically be using what we call the auto interpret. So the trend decider auto interpret does exactly what I was doing, now in an automatic fashion. So it shades it out for you that, okay, from that point it's bearish, and from that point it's bullish. And the nice thing is, the light blue is when two factors, so you can see over here, you've got, you know, this is really bullish, and here it's below the daily, but it's still above the weekly. So, you know, you still got one negative factor, so that's why light blue. So it's beautifully color-coded in, and of course you'd find more details in the manual and the follow-up training that we provide. But that's how simple it is. And when you look at the watch list, you see bullish, bearish, minus, minus, minus. That's so intuitive, because when you see bearish, it means all the factors are weak. When you see minus, 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 it means two out of three factors are weak. So what are the weak and strength, the strong and weak factors I'm looking at? We're looking at three thumb rules for a buy, which is close above the daily level, close above the weekly level, and of course, if the green line is above the red line, which means my daily is above the weekly, that's strong. And if the daily is below the weekly, it's weak. And wherever they cross over, really, where the daily just gets above the weekly or vice versa, that's where the trend changes. Now, you do have alerts within the power screener which talk to you about where the trend has just changed, where it is bearish or bullish already. So when you see bearish and bullish, it doesn't mean it's a new signal. It means it's already bearish or already bullish. Whenever it does change, you would actually get trend change alert on whatever your symbol name is. So that gives you a sense as to what the trend decider can do for you. So all that's automatically interpreted, not just on your watch list, but also on the chart. So trend changes are, you know, detected exactly like I just explained. And you know, the idea of going through it manually once is so that you understand what the auto interpreters are doing. Now, look at the little diamonds that I've marked there. Those are points where all the three criteria are met. So let's take the first one. The sell criteria are met here because we have close below the daily and the weekly, and the green or the daily level is lower than the weekly level. All signs of weakness, and boom, we went down. Why is it a buy over here? Why is the trend changed upwards? Because we've got a close above daily and weekly, and the green line is now above the red. So pretty straight cut. Now, you do have a lot of these occasional pointers where you can see, look at the little circles I'm now just marking up. These are points where the market closed above the daily and the weekly, but you know what? The green was still lower than the red, and I'm not going to be very sure in these trades, and that's what saves you. In fact, use these little pullbacks up as opportunity to sell if you can see that there's already an established trend to take sell trades. So the trend decider is, again, an amazing tool which automatically detects trend change, automatically marks that trend change out for you, and you can apply them on interval charts. So if you're looking at daily and weekly, you can apply it on a 5 minute, 15 minute, whatever you trade, but the level of the daily and the weekly will stay the same irrespective of what time frame you use, because it's working to set time horizons, which is nice because you get that little stability you're looking at. And last one I really want to cover quickly is the counter trend indicator. The counter trend indicator is an exclusive tool we built to decide where the market is changing trend, you know, or reversing trend. So we're looking at reversals when potentially there are price bars which have very high volatility, very high volume, and you know, when those price zones really break out, where the volume and the volatility accumulated out, it would mark straight cut buy and sell signals. Now, you should of course confirm that with things like the zone detector or, you know, any other studies you want to add in, but counter trend was built to be you know, something very standalone and something which detects counter trend opportunity. So on this hourly here, I just put the counter trend indicator on, and that's what you get, straight cut buy and sell signals. And that's an Apple hourly chart that I have here. And wherever you get these are going to happen while the market ticks. And you know, a lot of the indicators are very easy to use, because when you see sell, all I need to do is, okay, use the simple rule, sell below the low of the bar, because sometimes you do get sell, but the low of the bar is never broken. Look at the two green lines that are plotted there. We cannot take these trades, because even though it's marked to buy or sell, we've not triggered, we've not pushed out the high or low of that bar. So what are the trades I could take? I could definitely take that trade, definitely take that trade, because it takes the high out. It's not just to buy the next one or two bars, kick the high out and confirm up. I can take the sell because I've broken the lowdown of the cell bar. And you know that lets me take the cell trade. And here too, we've got power screeners, which give you counter trend opportunities to detect these different trading signals. So here it is on. So you can use it on intraday timeframes too. So let's just remove all the bodies, and I'll just put on the counter trend indicator. And the way you do is go to ATM counter trend. And you can see there's a chart window power screener. I'm going to apply it on the chart. Now to start with, you can see there are loads of buys and sells that come. But what you want to do is, you know, filter them out. Double click on it, display filtered signals. It would automatically just detect the first buy or the first sell. For example, you may say, all right, I don't want to see every single sell that comes up because they just add on sells and they just, I don't need buy there. I just want to see that one buy or the first one or what's more relevantly the first signal and what it believes is going to be more counter. So there you are. It does a full nice cleanup and all I get is the first buy and the first sell. Now again, it's not a perfect world out there because you do have the odd breakdown there. It doesn't work. What's the stop I use? I'm going to use immediate high that I made, and that's the risk that I'm taking. But if you do workout, it's almost like again detecting, you know, short-term top or bottom, and that's bingo. That buy. So it's not just how accurate is it in terms of always it's 7 out of 10 accurate. It's all about look when it's right. You know, you can get 1:1.5, 1:2, 1:3. That's what matters more. The risk is to reward is very neat and. You know, that's a philosophy I've really worked with in all my trading. It's not about having 8 out of 10 trades correct. It's about, you know, how accurate are your winners and, you know, how controlled are the risks that you're taking. So fairly defined strategies, you'd find more definition, you know, on the manual that we made. And finally, you can build up power screeners, which really could be of different time frames, different indicators. So right on this chart, you can see I've got a tick, an RMO2, an SWI, the breakout catcher, the counter trend, everything I talked about today, and you know, banged it in into one nice watch list on time frames I want to use, on symbols I want to track and trade, and you know, it does it you know, pretty decently from there. So. That gives you a basic roundup of what the ATM power screener is. Well, you've got to use it to feel it and believe it. And, you know, we've done, as I said, we've got hundreds of users across the globe. You know, whether you're trading the Australian market, whether you're trading the FX markets or the US market. So, and, you know, it's really evolved as a product with a lot of customer feedback as well. And, you know, you can see all the approaches are fairly direct. They're not indirect hints of whether to buy or sell because sometimes you land up buying products which gives you two or three strategies. This one's fairly complete, very comprehensive, whether it's short-term, long-term, weekly, daily, monthly, all of that stuff. You know, indicators which address needs for breakouts, counter trends, trend decider levels, trailing models. We've built in a lot, and that's exactly why it takes me back to saying that look, it's not just a black box, and I don't want it to, you know, get that tag unnecessarily because it's really built as a piece of studies which, you know, which can integrate so well to help you practically, and you know, brings me back to the same thing. You've got to build in a more hands-free approach, a more visual approach. An approach which makes you less of the analyst, more of the trader, and I can't stress how important that is. You know, it's not just giving you a quantity of studies, but it's also giving you a quality of studies, which is something we've really worked around for very long periods of time. And as Ben just introduced you, you know, we've been a very old partner with eSignal. We date back to the 1990s when we started selling Get with Tom Joseph. We've been 20 years in business in India, and you know, we've dedicated ourselves to technical analysis. We're not brokers. Technical analysis is all we do and focus on. We've got, a suite of 20 different studies out there. You've got practical training to back you up. So when you buy the program, we could help set up a training session for you to help you use the product a lot better. And, once you're signed up, you can also go through those manuals. They're pretty well done and quite detailed. So that would give you a good insight too. Now I'm going to throw it open for questions right now, and let's just get back to the
chat
and Ben, you can take over.
Yeah, hello folks, this is Ben again. So it looks like Anita sent in a question regarding, does the zone detector work with Forex?
The zone detector could work with Forex, because the nice thing is, if you have a symbol that does carry volume data. Now, I do know provider data does have, let's say if I'm looking at a euro at the rate TDFX or euro at the rate GFT, they do carry some volume data too. So as long as you have volume data, it does work, and that should take care of it. But if you're looking at it on an index which does not trade or does not have volume data, it's not going to work. But
you can
use it on index futures.
Thank you, Rahul. Another question coming in from Rahul is, what is the accuracy of the ATM tool?
Well, there's a suite of tools, and I was trying to address this. Well, broadly, it's a lot of risk-reward which is married into this, but all the systems would really range anywhere from a 60 to 80% hit rate. And, when you start using it, I think what I want you to pay a little more focus to is the risk is to reward ratio, like the squeeze trade setups. I mean, if you get a setup which is 1-for-2 and you get 6 of them right, I mean, boy, that's a good deal.
Okay. Amit had a couple of questions. The first being, can I get this presentation link? And yes, Amit, what I will do is, after this webinar, which is being recorded, we will send a link to the video posted on YouTube, as well as I will secure this PowerPoint presentation from Rahul and include it as part of the thank you email for attending this webinar. Also, you had a question regarding the price for individual package. Are you referring to the ATM PowerScreener package, Amit, or something else? Oh, so I do have... Let me pull up my document, which indicates the pricing of the product. So for attending today's webinar, the special offer for today is, if you subscribe to the PowerScreener indicator, you get the second month free. Otherwise, monthly price is $209 USD. Or you can prepay annually, and your cost will be roughly $159 per month. Rahul, you had another question. How to stop out in RMO2 model? Rahul, can you provide a little bit of a response?
Well, the RMO2 is very simple, because let's say you're trading on the pullback. So let's say you buy call options when the RMO2 pulled back from +1 to 0. You buy calls. And the idea of buying calls is you're trying to get into a point where you're cornering a bottom or a short-term bottom. So if the RMO2 goes to -1 from there, you can stop out, right then. And alternatively, if you're willing to give it a wait, well, and you feel that you want to give this more time, you bought call options, which is a more defined risk or limited risk, you could continue with that trade. But yes, to answer your question clearly, you do stop out when from a pullback, let's say you've got a buy pullback, and you go to a -1 value, that's when you stop out.
Okay. Thank you, Rahul. It looks like Mayank has a question regarding, is this price with data and all other stuff needed to use this product?
The PowerScreener is an add-on to eSignal. So if you are already subscribed to eSignal, whether it is eSignal Premier or Premier Plus, and you can get hold of the pricing on eSignal.com. The data is not included. The data or the exchange fees is something you need to first subscribe to as the eSignal product. The ATM PowerScreener comes as an add-on, a suite of indicators, And, you know, we don't sell the indicators separately. It's one big suite with everything right up to the scanning capabilities, the voice alerts, all the different chart indicators, the auto interpreters. It's one big package as in the add-on. The add-on costs $209 a month or $159 prepaid, and that does not include data.
Okay. Amit sent in another question. Can I use PowerScreener
for
Indian market?
Yeah, we have scores of users already using it with the NSC, PSC, with the MCX exchange. So yes, very clearly you can definitely use it with the Indian market. Very, very liquid.
Okay. Let's give another minute or two for any final questions. At this time, does anyone have any final questions? It looks like Chirag is typing something right now. Chirag's question is there any facility to back test this system?
No, we've got a we've got back testers which we're still building in, but then again we've done a lot of testing on the individual setups, but there's a lot to integrate, and which doesn't necessarily mean that you can program each and every aspect of it. For example, looking at the quality of the trade with the light blue or the dark blue, quantifying it from there, or waiting for a high or low to kick out, or looking at the zone detector. So a lot of this cannot necessarily be perfectly programmed and backtested, but we've done initial backtests back in, and that's how it was really built off. Well, a lot of good tools, for that matter, I must add, do not have backtesters, right up to you know, some of the advanced CAD studies, which I really love. I mean, look at the MOB or the Ellipse. They work great, but then they're not necessarily stuff that you can backtest because of the complexity off the indicators.
Okay, thank you, Rahul. Ravi279, your question was, can we have a webinar during Indian time? Are you referring to more eSignal webinars or potentially having another webinar with Rahul and the subject matter related topic? PowerScreener. So it sounds like, Rahul, you have a request for additional webinars in Indian time. So let's take that offline and see what we can do to potentially reschedule another upcoming webinar.
We could do one with some live data too. Yeah, that's a good suggestion.
Right. Okay. Any other additional questions from the audience? We'll give it another 30 seconds to a minute. You're welcome, Chirag. Looks like ProTrader is typing something. And great presentation. You're welcome, ProTrader. Kudos to Rahul. Devin L. Wilson is typing something. These indicators are for binary options. Is that a question or a statement? Question.
No, it's just the RMO2 indicator, which is more designed for options. And as I said, if you are not trading in the options segment, you can still use the RMO2 for breakouts. That means when it goes into a plus one or a minus one. But all the other tools, you know, pretty much, whether it's the strength weakness index, the trend deciders, the trend intelligence kit or the tick system, the squeeze trades, the trend trades, they're just separate setups, and you know, they're not necessarily locked into binary models or option models.
Okay, thank you. Closing questions before we close off the webinar. Is there any additional questions? Okay. Let me go ahead and conclude this webinar. Again, this is Ben from eSignal. As a reminder, I've listed this final slide with information to learn how to contact Viratech Software and or eSignal regarding this product and any of the additional questions or product questions you may have. I would like to thank Rahul for taking time out of his schedule to spend time with us. I would also like to thank each and every one of you for coming to today's webinar. I hope you found this webinar beneficial. If you have any follow-up questions, please do not hesitate to contact either Viratech Software or eSignal. We would be more than happy to answer any questions you may have. And as a reminder, you will be receiving a recorded copy of this webinar as a thank you for attending. We hope you have enjoyed this webinar and will join us again soon. Thank you and have a good rest of your day. Thank you. So Rahul, are you still there?
Yep.
So Rahul, I've closed off the room so no one can hear us right now. I thought it was a very good presentation. It was very informative. You were very engaging. You know, lots of good questions, and it sounds like there's an appetite to schedule a follow-up webinar in the Indian market. So. You know, that's great. That's great on your behalf. It sounds like, you know, I know that's your deep market, but, you know, if you have some people that would love to hear more during your time, that would be great.
We already do some, actually, so maybe if these guys, you know, send us their email, we can schedule them for them exclusively. So we usually do a lot of demos one-to-one and live markets too, so that shouldn't be a problem.